Before this episode starts, I just want to give a little disclaimer that the color is kind of off. A lot of it was filmed just in the tent outside of the boat itself. Everything turned super yellow, and even though I can try my hand a little bit at color grading, it usually doesn't get that yellow tinge out. So I apologize beforehand. That's going to like not look the greatest. And if anyone has color grading skills, you know I try the regular stuff, but if there's a special trick, please let me know, because it drives me crazy every time this happens. We are now getting back to that warm weather phase of the year where we can use our methacrylate bonding agent, and that's what allows us to bond all of those big pieces from our kit together before we go through and glass them after the fact. And one of the biggest ones that we haven't paid attention to, we didn't get around to it last year because we ran out of methacrylate, is the cabin top, which is currently in three pieces. So we're going to be getting that bonded on in the next few days. But Matt has spent a bit of his time getting in Tyvek and kind of cleaning up that area because it has the gel coat over the flanges that need to overlap and bond together. So he's just going to be prepping that, be doing some test fittings, get those three pieces into one, and then we'll be able to bond it to the cabin top. But first, we are going to need to get our compression post from the welder. We got an email from him that it should be ready in the next few days, because that needs to be in place before we can bond the cabin top down, and we can't put that in once the cabin's already in. So that's kind of been the holdup too, but at least we're making some steps forward now.
As you can see behind me, we do have all the gel coat now stripped off of the flanges around this side and this side. But today I'm going to prep the inner surface in here where that mates on top of this flange. And then also, because this is going to be my one opportunity to really get to them, I've already prepped the cabin top flange. So that big piece that's in there that's molded right up in there. But the part that's going to mate to this actual cabin top, the strip along there is where that flange is going to mate from the cabin side to the cabin top. And this is my one opportunity to get access to it and prep that surface properly before we end up bonding them all together. So that's going to be my day. A lot more sanding, but we're getting there. We should be able to bond these together then in the next day or two. And then I can start that extra lamination process. It's going to go through and tie these all together.
Super busy day in the yard. The guys have so many boats to move, so I apologize if there's going to be a lot of like on and off noises in the background. And we also have people sanding their boats to get ready to go in the water. There's like a week and a half left until charter fishing season begins, so yeah, everyone's scrambling. So nice having all these openings. Let natural light back inside.
Yeah, do that deck hatch right there. Match that guy.
Yeah, need one more deck hatch to fall into.
Yeah. I should believe in the room up there. And you can still see all the
plastic bubble wraps.
Basically, yeah, bubble wraps.
That we received this in. It's going to need a nice scrubbing.
It is going to need a very nice scrubbing before it gets the sun to bake it in.
Yeah, oh sure, I didn't think about that. Almost weren't able to use our big scale because I was out of batteries, and I, for the life of me, could not find AAAs. Just tore the Viking apart, had to take them out of like one of those little lights you stick in a closet. But now we're good to go.
See the line? line on it.
No? Oh, geez, what is that? It's a fashion statement.
Yeah.
I think I walked into like a cord. No, I'm just gonna leave it because it's cool. We're just about to start mixing the methacrylate right now, and it is good with the newest batch we've gotten this past year that it has a longer work time. A little bit annoying when you're doing the test and you think that it hasn't cured, but in hotter temperatures it will be good, as well as now, because we only have the two of us here, and that way we can spread it on and not be worried about time. I can do some filming a little bit better, and then it has the rest of the day to cure. So let's get a move on. Time to start measuring that out. Zero out the scale.
Okay. Our unit button is maybe stuck.
Oh no.
Oh, there it goes.
Okay.
This by weight, by volume, that's a 10 to 1. By weight, it's an 8.4 to 1 ratio for this stuff. So zero this out, we need to do 1780 grams, so 1.78 kilos, to 212. And that will give us enough with a little left over to do this flange and make sure that we're properly filling it. There's gonna be no voids or low spots there. The last of the mass free time. The rest of it, we're gonna need the mass on because this stuff is potent.
And notice how I have Matt doing all the talking of the flanges instead of me.
Two keys missing.
And to give you an idea of what the cost is for this type of stuff, what we're looking at right here is about $1,000 worth of adhesive. So it is not an inexpensive process, and it's a one-time only thing. If you screw it up, there's no going back, which we found out with the cockpit seats. So it's very, very important to get it right the first time.
We decided to go a little low. We didn't want to overmake it, seeing as it is that expensive. So we're at 1526. Throw that in the calculator, divided by 8.4. So we're gonna need 181.6 grams of the catalyst down here. Nice gray color.
And what does that bring us up to total?
1707. We need a total of 1707.6. Yeah, a little bit more to go. Mixing has started at 11:17 a.m.
This little guy is definitely more for liquidy stuff.
So we're using piping bags like this to fill, so we can squirt it out. They've already had the ends cut off, and I've just set them inside other containers that are gonna make them easier to fill.
Let's do this.
Cleaned that bucket out. Got about three bags. Matt is still working on the first, so let's see how application is going up on deck.
Well, even that, I need you to come back and start filling.
Okay. So not only has Matt gone through already and smoothed that out, but then we had enough to go back and do a couple more beads, which are gonna get smoothed out again. And then we'll be able to lower it in place. After setting down the camera so that we could properly align these two parts of the cabin top, as you can see, it has our cleats in it, which we've done for pretty much every other seam. It's finally at a point that we just can't touch it anymore.
As always, we went through and we thought we had the process. We dry fit, we went through the process a couple of times just to make sure everything was setting properly. Did everything we could to prepare for it. And then when we did it, it was not aligning. The two halves, the two pieces, were getting, it's basically a high spot here now, and it flows properly this direction and flows properly this direction, but we have a high spot there. And for no matter what we did, we couldn't get it to not have that actually happen. We tried pulling this up. We tried putting this down. If you had put that down, that creates a valley rig at that point. It was fun, real good times. But I think we have it now aligned properly. Once I do the glass work here to pull these seams together anyway, that should end up getting rid of that high spot and get that so it's a nice transition from side to side there. And then we're just gonna load it full of solar and you're never gonna see it.
That night, maybe that's why it felt so right. Do I really need to spit it out for you? So why are you trying to hide your curiosity when I know you call my name out in your sleep? Tell me, friend, can't you see you're in love with me? It's obvious we are that. Feels good to be honest. Can't you admit that you want this? Everybody knows it except for you. When you're lying there on your deathbed, you will regret you kept quiet. Also not telling me straight up.
It's amazing how much better things go when your expectations are low. After yesterday doing this side and being thoroughly confused as to why the dry fitting ended up completely different than when we had the adhesive in there, and panicking and trying to get everything aligned, This side, of course, with zero effort, fell into place. I mean, it was such a simple process, filling that in, going through, making sure everything was level with where it's supposed to be. Experience, I think it's just experience talking now, getting a feel for this, but very happy. The plan for the next couple of days, you might be able to see I'm sweating right now. It's 80 something degrees up here, so I'm not gonna get in Tyvek and clean the seams out. I'm gonna wait until the next couple of days. It's gonna drop down a little bit lower temperature and will allow me to get into full gear. Go through, then end up cutting back the gel coat here. We will glass and fair this time before we end up spraying new gel coat in this area. But I also have to do the reverse side. So the under part here needs to get glassed, and then I need to reinforce this section, which is where the jib track is gonna go, salt tacking. And then all the way back there, where the traveler goes, I need to reinforce that area too. So that's gonna be quite the project. All the extra laminations that go into this to make this sure it's a very strong structure. But that's basically the process for the next couple of weeks.